In this video, we're going to define some buzzwords that you may have heard floating around the AI space: deep learning, machine learning, and how these fit within the AI world. So here's what you need to know in a single sentence. Machine learning is a type of artificial intelligence. Deep learning is an especially complex part of machine learning. What is machine learning? Machine learning is the general term for when computers learn from data. It describes the intersect of computer science and statistics. In this field, algorithms perform a specific task without being explicitly programmed. Instead, they recognize the patterns in data and make predictions once new data arrives. In general, the learning process of these algorithms can be either unsupervised or supervised, depending on the data being used to feed the algorithms. A traditional machine learning algorithm can be something as simple as linear regression. For instance, imagine you want to predict your income given your years of higher education. In a first step, you have to define a function. For example, income equals y plus x times years of experience. Then give your algorithm a set of training data. This could be a simple table with data on some people's years of higher education and their associated income. Next, let your algorithm draw the line, for example, through an ordinary least squares OLS regression. Now you can give the algorithm some test data, for example, your personal years of higher education, and let it predict your income. While this sounds simple, it does count as machine learning, and yes, the driving force behind machine learning is ordinary statistics. The algorithm learned to make a prediction without being explicitly programmed, only based on patterns and inference. To recap, machine learning is at the intersection of computer science and statistics. This is the means through which computers receive the ability to learn without being explicitly programmed. There are two broad categories of machine learning problems: supervised and unsupervised learning. A machine learning algorithm can be something as simple as an OLS regression. Now, let's examine how the term deep learning relates to all of this. What is deep learning? Deep learning algorithms can be regarded both as a sophisticated and mathematically complex evolution of machine learning algorithms. This field has been getting lots of attention lately in the mainstream because there's been an explosion in deep learning technology. Deep learning describes algorithms that analyze data with a logic structure similar to how a human would draw conclusions. This can happen both through supervised and unsupervised learning. To achieve this, deep learning applications use a layered structure of algorithms called an artificial neural network, ANN. The design of such an ANN is inspired by the biological neural network of the human brain, leading to a process of learning that's far more capable than that of standard machine learning models. This is what a simple artificial neural network looks like. The leftmost layer is called the input layer, the rightmost layer is the output layer. The middle layers are called hidden layers because their values aren't observable in the training set. In simple terms, hidden layers are the calculated values used by the network to do its magic. The more hidden layers a network has between the input and output layers, the deeper it is. In general, any ANN with two or more hidden layers is referred to as a deep neural network. Applications of deep learning. Deep learning is used in many fields. In automated driving, for instance, deep learning is used to detect objects such as stop signs or pedestrians. Imagine the company Tesla using a deep learning algorithm for its cars to recognize stop signs. In the first step, the ANN would identify the relevant properties of the stop sign, also called features. Features may be specific structures in the inputted image, such as points, edges, or objects. The military uses deep learning to identify objects from satellites, for example, to discover safe or unsafe zones for its troops. And the consumer electronics industry is full of deep learning too. Home assistant devices such as Amazon Alexa, for example, rely on deep learning algorithms to respond to your voice and know your preferences. While a software engineer would have to select the relevant features in a more traditional machine learning algorithm, the ANN is capable of automatic feature engineering. The first hidden layer might learn how to detect edges, the next how to differentiate colors, and the last learn how to detect more complex shapes catered specifically to the shape of the object we're trying to recognize. When fed with training data, the deep learning algorithms would eventually learn from their own errors whether the prediction was good or whether it needs to adjust. What the job of a neuron in an ANN actually looks like. Overall, through automatic feature engineering and its self-learning capabilities, the deep learning algorithms need only little human intervention. While this shows the huge potential of deep learning, there are two main reasons why it has only recently attained so much usability: data availability and computing power. Firstly, deep learning requires incredibly vast amounts of data, We'll get to exceptions to that rule in a minute. Tesla's autonomous driving software, for instance, needs millions of images and video hours to function properly. Secondly, deep learning needs substantial computing power. However, with the emergence of cloud computing infrastructure and high-performing GPUs, graphic processing units used for faster calculations, the time for training a deep learning network could be reduced from weeks to mere hours. But probably one of the most important advances in the field of deep learning is the emergence of transfer learning, that is, the use of pre-trained models. The reason? Transfer learning can be regarded as a cure for the needs of large data training sets that were necessary for ANNs to produce meaningful results. These enormous data needs used to be the reason why ANN algorithms weren't considered to be the optimal solutions to all problems in the past. However, for many applications, this need for data can now be satisfied by using pre-trained models. The main differences between machine learning and deep learning. This is a common question, and if you have watched this far, you probably know it's not the right one to ask. Deep learning algorithms are machine learning algorithms. Therefore, it might be better to think about what makes deep learning special within the field of machine learning. The answer? The ANN algorithm structure, the lower need for human intervention, and the large data requirements. First and foremost, while traditional machine learning algorithms have a rather simple structure, such as linear regression or a decision tree, deep learning is based on an artificial neural network. This multi-layered ANN is, like a human brain, complex and intertwined. Secondly, deep learning algorithms require much less human intervention. Remember the Tesla example? If the stop sign image recognition was a more traditional machine learning algorithm, a software engineer would manually choose features and a classifier to sort images, check the output is as required, and adjust the algorithm if this is not the case. As a deep learning algorithm, however, the features are extracted automatically and the algorithm learns from its own errors. The deep learning algorithm doesn't need a software engineer to identify features, but is capable of automatic feature engineering through its neural network. Thirdly, deep learning requires much more data than a traditional machine learning algorithm to function properly. Machine learning works with 1,000 data points, deep learning oftentimes only with millions. Due to the complex multi-layer structure, a deep learning system needs a large data set to eliminate fluctuations and make high-quality interpretations. Don't forget to subscribe if you're looking for more introductory level guides to machine learning, and get in touch with us to learn more about creating your own AI without code.